So let's analyze properties of a symbol sequence generated by the logistic equation. So here I'll think about a symbol sequence generated from an orbit of the logistic equation, and this is with r equals 4.0. So this is a chaotic value, it's aperiodic and has sensitive dependence on initial conditions. And I'm going to imagine doing an experiment, and I'm going to do another experiment side by side, and I'm going to imagine tossing a fair coin many, many times. So if I tossed a fair coin, the outcomes are heads and tails. Probability of heads is a half, probability of tails is a half, and the tosses are independent, meaning that the outcome of one toss has no influence on the outcome of the next toss or any other toss. The symbol sequence, I would get the orbit, and then I would convert that to L's and R's. And what I want to do is compare the statistical features of these L's and R's to the statistical features of these H's and T's. And I'm going to imagine that we have an infinite amount of data. So we've done this infinitely long and done this infinitely long. Okay, that's a little bit unrealistic, but it'll simplify the discussion, and I'll talk about that again in a bit. Okay, so the first thing we might do, we have this infinitely long string sequence of L's and R's. We could say, what's the frequency of L? What's the frequency of R? And if we did that, we would find that half of these symbols were L and half were R. And we could do the same thing here. I've tossed a fair coin a million, a billion, an infinite number of times, and we could ask the same question, what's the frequency of H? What's the frequency of R? And the frequency of H is a half. Frequency of tails is a half. So all this says is the heads and tails are equally likely, occur equally often, and the L's and R's occur equally often. Doesn't mean the sequences are the same or have the same statistical features. It just means that the statistics or the frequency of a single symbol are the same. So now let's do another experiment. Let's ask about the frequency of LL, RL, R, LL, RL, LR, and RR. I better not say that and write that instead. So, okay, so what I was trying to say is the frequency of these outcomes. So if I scanned down this very long string and said, how often do I see, or what fraction of the time do I see an LL together, what fraction of the time do I see an LR, RL, and RR? And that would be a quarter for all of these. All of the four possible pairs are equally likely. The same thing will happen to over here. So if I ask, what's the frequency of H, 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 T, 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 and T, H, I would see a similar thing. So the frequency of all possible pairs, the frequencies are all equal. They're all equally likely. And the frequency of all possible pairs here are all equally likely. And you can probably guess the next step. Let's ask about the frequency of all possible triples, LLL, LLR, LRL, and so on. Okay, so for the symbolic dynamics, the symbolic sequence from the logistic equation, there are eight possible outcomes of three consecutive symbols, LLL, LLR, and so on, and they all occur equally likely with a fraction of an eighth. And it's the same story for the fair coin. There are eight possible outcomes of three consecutive symbols, HHH, HTH, and so on, And they all occur equally likely, equally often. Their frequencies are the same, 1/8. I could keep doing these experiments. I could look at 4 consecutive symbols, 5 consecutive symbols, 6 consecutive symbols for both of these situations, and I would see in all cases, all sequences occur equally often. So if I considered all 5 sequences of 5 possible coin tosses, I'll see they occur with equal frequency. Same story with the L's and R's over here. So what this means is that the logistic equation, or the, in particular the symbolic dynamics from the logistic equation with R equals 4, are as random as a coin toss. So that's an important result that I want to think about for a bit, so let me write that down. So the logistic equation with R equals 4 is as random as a coin toss. For a coin toss, all possible sequences of H's and T's are equally likely. For the logistic equation, all possible sequence of L's and R's are equally likely. Here's another way to think about what this means. Suppose I were to generate 2 symbolic sequences. And again, the names of the letters don't matter. I could use H's and T's or zeros and ones. The letters are arbitrary. One of those very long symbol sequences I generated by tossing a coin again and again and again and again. The other symbol sequence I would generate by iterating the logistic equation again and again and again and again, and then writing it in symbolic form. And then I handed you those 2 sequences, and I asked you to tell me which was which. There would be no way, what this means is, there would be no way to tell those 2 sequences apart. One is generated by a fair coin, what we think of as sort of the most random process imaginable. The other sequence is generated by iterating a function, about as deterministic as it gets. Nevertheless, their outcomes are indistinguishable. Now, I should mention that, of course, if we were to do this experiment in real life, we can't have an infinite sequence of fair coin tosses or iterates. So we'll have a very long one. These wouldn't be exactly an eighth. These all wouldn't be exactly an eighth. Some would be a little bit more, a little bit less. But it wouldn't affect the overall argument that in the limit that the sequences get longer and longer and longer, all of these frequencies become the same, and all of these frequencies become the same. And the two sequences are indistinguishable. So we just saw an example of a deterministic function producing a random outcome. And not just a random outcome, but an outcome that I said is in a sense as random as a fair coin. So deterministically iterating a function produces something that's indistinguishable from a random coin toss. So that seems really weird, and we're going to talk about that in a second. But first, I want to point out that this discovery that iterating the logistic equation, turning it into symbolic dynamics, makes something that looks like a fair coin, is actually a tremendously useful result, because randomness is actually a really useful resource in science and in our lives. Having access to randomness is, in a sense, a good thing. So let me explain what I mean by this. In many numerical algorithms, one does what's called a Monte Carlo simulation, and that requires access to a good source of random numbers, because it requires some sort of random sampling of some sort of a space. In statistics, it's really important to work with what's called an unbiased sample. You want to get a random sample. Say you have a really big population, 1 million people in a country or a state or something, and you want to figure out their statistical properties, some average income, who knows. You want to make sure that, okay, you could ask all 1 million people, that probably takes too long. So instead you'll ask some smaller sample, but you want that smaller sample of your larger population to be representative of the whole. And the best way to do that is to do a random sample. It's not always easy or clear to know how to do that, but having access to some sort of good randomness algorithm, if that even makes sense, it does, as we'll see, is a very useful thing. In other activities, randomness is also a useful resource. So if I'm engaged in some strategic interaction with some opponent, and that could be bargaining, that could be, running away from somebody that's trying to catch me, evading somebody that's trying to do something bad to me. I want my actions to be as unpredictable as possible. If there are regularities in what I'm doing, then my opponent can exploit that regularity. And that could be in a game like Prisoner's Dilemma or Rock, Paper, Scissors, or in some other sort of physical situation where I'm running away from somebody and I want to move left and right with equal probabilities. So in strategic interactions, if you're random, then there's no regularities that an opponent can exploit. Very similar story in cryptography. There's lots of different ways to do cryptography, but one way is you need some symbol sequence, some symbol sequence that you use to encode the message you want to keep secret. And the sequence that I'm using as part of that encoding scheme needs to be as random or as close to random as possible. Because if there are regularities in that encoding sequence, then an opponent can exploit that and could maybe figure out what my secret message is. So anyway, the point of all this is that maybe we think of randomness as something unwanted, and often it is unwanted. I don't want my car to like randomly start in the morning or not. I'd like to know that even when it's really cold out, it's going to start. So often we think of randomness as something to avoid, but randomness actually is a really useful resource. So the logistic equation with R equals 4 can generate numbers, or bits, zeros and ones, that can be used as a random number generator, which is really useful in all sorts of applications. Now, I'm not an expert in random number generators, but I don't think that the logistic equation in this exact form is used in random number generators. However, it's the same basic idea. One is iterating, not one, the computer iterates a deterministic function that is chaotic and so produces this random outcome, and then that serves as a source of randomness for whatever it is your computer is trying to do. So randomness is actually a useful resource in many circumstances. In any event, in the next lecture, we'll dig deeper into randomness because we clearly have to think a little bit more about what randomness means, given that we have a deterministic system producing a random result.